All right. Before we get on to emails here, I got to play a little bit of this thing right here. Just a little bit.
Okay.
This is one of the most embarrassing commercials I've seen in a long time. It's the official death of hip-hop, if you want to consider it that way. I mean, right when you thought they could not embarrass hip-hop anymore. Right when the mainstream couldn't take it and just
co-opted it.
And co-opted and make it ugly, make it embarrassing, make it cringeworthy.
Now, does this beat MC Hammer's Taco Bell commercial?
By a long shot. By a long shot, man. Yeah. And what's worse about it is that when you do something that is almost a terrible parody of hip-hop, and then you actually have a figure of hip-hop, an actual rapper come in and participate, it's just sad, man. So we got,
because that means it's official.
It's dead. Is that mainstream? Look, the fringes of hip hop still alive. They're still doing original mainstream shit. It's that mainstream shit that's
been
just
dead for.
That mainstream shit is just gone.
Just gone. Been dead since like,
the moment y'all put some shit in a Toyota minivan commercial, and I'm not saying this to talk about white people. Because I think this is insulting to white people. This is a ad agency that thought it would be funny to take that old tried but true idea of taking corny white people or corny looking white people and putting them in a commercial where they're rapping.
Okay.
And it contradicts how corny they really look.
That never gets old.
No, it never gets old.
Wait, hold on.
No.
Yes, it does.
No, Martin. It does not. It does not. I mean, what you talking about? Take a look at this. Shut your mouth until you see it.
Right. Listen up, mother fathers.
What?
This one's about the swagger wagon.
Already out the gate. Shit is bad.
Yeah.
Listen up, mother fathers. And look at the girl, the way she starts rolling her neck and everything.
I wash your mouth out with soap if you call it a minivan. That's a dirty word. Drop that beat.
Yeah, it's called the swagger wagon. I know that it sounds like bragging.
Oh,
when
dude.
We pull up to karate, other parents' tongues are wagging. They be like, who that is? It's just us and the kids. It's wagging hard until it's dark. Getting home around 8 p.m.
Then it's lights out, kids, okay?
Aww.
Hey, rules are rules.
We gonna roll in the swagger wagon.
God damn.
Jesus.
God damn. And meanwhile, this must be a shitty car because they don't tell you anything about it.
You don't even see it
the whole time.
Well, I'm sure it's been like, man, we can't find any way to make minivans cool. That's the one thing that's holding us back. We got to try something.
You know what's cool? Hip hop.
Yeah.
Right.
And meanwhile, you just made the minivan look like the most uncool piece of shit out
actually,
there.
Actually,
right
already
now.
Was.
I have the secret as to how to make minivans cool.
Don't do a commercial like this?
Well, yeah.
Okay, what else?
Take the doors off and just put giant speakers in there. So when you roll down, they're blasting out both sides.
No, Mart, no. Because then you wouldn't be looking up like looking like this shit. They doing Soulja Boy shit.
Yeah, they doing Soulja Boy
they
shit.
Got a, they using a beat from like fucking 6-7 years ago. And they out there doing the Soulja Boy?
Yeah.
The fuck is up? This goes to show you. This was a fucking ad agency.
All white.
All white. And all pretty much insulated from the rest of the world.
Exactly.
We got an idea for you.
They just discovered this.
No, they would have had somebody African American on staff who they would have run it by and say like, is this cool? And he'd be like,
Yeah.
Because he's like, yeah, check's gonna clear.
They pay me for it to say this. Yeah, it's fine.
Yeah, they pay me just to say, oh no, this is sensitive and this is cool, it's fine. They're going to do it whether I say it or not.
Yeah. Let me just stay in the good graces and give them the thumbs up. Oh, yeah. You got street cred with that shit. Everybody going to be buying minivans. Minivans going to be all up in the hood now.
It's a black day. Wipe off your shoes.
Oh, this is fucking embarrassing.
Swagger, wagger.
Our swag's smooth and butter. It's lighter than thunder. We kicking like
look at this
thunder.
Shit.
Imagine bad jumpers. Can see bumps over the limit. Pants on time, never late 1 minute. Homework turned in right around 6. Getting everything on the holiday with.
Black people who want to look hard, they just going to start having to put spikes in their head and get fangs and shit. They're going to have to be, you know, because once you see this shit is the style is taken. Like that regular street cred shit, the regular way of being hard, Not anymore. Nope. I just want to, before we go, I just want to get to one small part of the video. I got to show my man who came in to because with these kind of things, to add some legitimacy to the joke, you got to bring in one black person.
Is this commercial actually running on TV? Because it's awful long.
I think it's an internet commercial.
Okay.
Oh, wait a minute. Hold on, Martin. But wait a minute. No, this commercial, no, this shit's legit, man, because we got a real hip hopper coming through.
Look forward to this.
Oh, shit.
Look, I done been around the world.
Busta Rhymes. Oh. By the way.
That's Busta Rhymes.
Let me ask you a question. Real quick.
Shit.
Just showed up on set.
Oh, just showed up. Just showed up. And by the way, let me ask you a question. Which one is Busta Rhymes and which one is the minivan?
I know, right? It's like, did he eat Busta Rhymes?
It looks like. Looks like he was eating something real big and he got caught in the middle.
Got caught in the middle.
Like, get all the way to his stomach.
Yeah.
What the fuck is wrong with Busta?
Look like that family came out of him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We squint into the planet. It don't matter where we at. We keep it fresh down to the fabric. Keep it regal, sharp as a needle. You know that it's a habit. All my folks is powerful people.
That motherfucker like a turkey.
I thought it was Biz Markie at first.
You thought it was Biz Markie? You know what?
The guy thought it was Biz Markie.
I can see that.
Yeah.
Wow, I can see that.
Yeah.
Look like Biz Markie with some little baby dreads on his head. Looks like a fucking pumpkin with nappy hair. I can't.
He gets so broke he lost his dreads. He had to sell them off. Clearly he's hard up for money if he's doing some shit like this.
Yeah, did he sell the rest of his dreads?
Yo, how much can I get for these dookie braids right here?
Man, yeah, y'all are wrong. He ate something and got stuck in the middle.
Tommy, right? Look at that shit.
Look at it.
That motherfucker got a spare tire. Yeah. Like, he got a couple of them.
He does.
Shit, if that minivan's on flat, they can just get on him and ride him home.
Oh.
Yeah.
You remember, like, in cartoons when they would eat, like, something that's. Right.
Like, hey, make sure them two kids. Wait a minute, where's that little girl at? I think she's inside Busta Rhymes.
Like somebody put a T-shirt over a stack of ties.
Look at it. It looked like he's full right now. Yeah.
He just came from the buffet.
Yeah, look at.
Now black's supposed to make you slimmer.
No, not in this
That's
case.
A fail. Put that shit on MythBusters right now.
Oh, God damn. Shit. Wow, all right.
Oh, man.
All right, yeah, all right, all right. Enough of messing with my man Busta Rhymes right here. All right, everybody, let's go ahead. He still got more money than we do. Spend it all at the buffet today. All right, Busta, come on, man. You know better. You know better than this shit. Come on. It gets to a point you just turn a check down at some point.
Yeah, man, you got to.
Yeah, yeah, come on. This shit.
Have some self-respect.
Can you remember back in the day? When he would never do shit some like shit this. Like
Hell
this.
Hell no, wouldn't even think about it.
Yeah, man.
Entertain the idea.
But come on, you know, are we there yet?
But even then,
that's a big paycheck.
That's a big paycheck, and that's actually Cube with Cube Vision and playing product. You know, he's a producer on that and all that. You know, he's got control over that. This is somebody calling him up and saying, "Hey, can you come in and be the black person that makes people less angry at this?"
Yeah.
Well, you know what? I'm sure everybody like, look, we're just doing this for laughs. It's just a big joke. Just come and have fun with it.
You know what, man? I do understand that. On the flip side, I understand they went in very innocent, probably around all the boardroom. They were laughing at it. I know some people gonna probably think this. No, I'm not making any racial thing out of this or anything like
it's
that.
Not racist. No. Just corny as shit.
It's just corny.
Yeah.
Shit. You know what? I'll give you this much. If it was like an old black couple doing that shit out there, you know, rapping and all that, it'd be just as corny, man. Yeah. Come on, y'all. And you ad agencies,
fresh material.
All you ad agencies out there, you have your what not to do video right now.
And hip hop, get some fresh material.
No shit.
Man, today I read the comments on that, and somebody they said like I did because I was thinking the same thing, and somebody said it. They said, we officially have seen the death of hip hop. And there was a comment right below where somebody said, and that's a bad thing. And I couldn't argue. If this is what you know, then what am I supposed to tell you?
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah.
Sad day.
It's a sad day. Brought to us by a man. What was it? He went by some other name. The Watchman Preacher.
Come on, Ass, I think was his name.
Why did he use that name?
I don't know.
Can you get any creepier than that?
No.
Pretty creepy.
Yeah. That's why we always say Watchman Preacher.
Yeah.
That's a whole story behind that. We'll talk about it later, people. All right, all right, all right, all right, all right.
But is George Zimmerman looking at
he, man, did he not look like George Zimmerman?
Yes, he did.
Dude, when you saw George Zimmerman in the news, did you not think, that, I knew he was crazy. I knew he was going to fuck up.